Welcome to Super Return Asia. I'm Sarah Clark in Hong Kong, and I'm joined by Jie Gong, the partner at Pantheon Ventures and a member of the Asia Regional Investment Committee. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Sarah.
Let's look at infrastructure investing and the effects of technology on this sector. What are the trends and the themes shaping the technological aspect of infrastructure?
Broadly speaking, there are two very large themes. One is decarbonisation. The world is moving towards a low carbon environment. There's a lot of strategic and governmental will behind it. So I think that trend is going to shape the energy infrastructure area for a very long time to come. And the second is what I would call connectivity. By that I mean the explosion of data, both created and collected, and how that enables things, machines, devices to connect with each other. And that first results in a lot of efficiency gain, and that in itself also brings up new areas of infrastructure investment.
And which ones should investors then keep their eye on?
There are many to keep their eye on, dependent on which sector is their key focus. I would say in terms of the sectors that benefit from technological advancement, broadly three of them. The largest infrastructure space, as you know, is energy infrastructure. And that area is going to be continuously benefiting from the development of renewables. It will also further benefit from the development of energy storage. So that's really one area to watch. And the second one is on the transportation. The future is going to be a world dominated by autonomous self-driving vehicles. So our roads, our transportation infrastructure needs to be enabled by sensors to be able to integrate that new, you know, vehicles of the future. So that's another very large area to watch out for. And the third is 5G itself is a game changer. And that will also create a lot of space for the network infrastructure investment.
Okay, so what are the infrastructure opportunities that these new technologies are opening up for investors?
Yeah, there are two buckets of opportunities. First is areas that are new. I would say, for example, data center. There's a new iteration of data center that is able to accommodate the cloud computing, and there's, you know, opportunity that is quite proliferating that area. And another bucket I would call really improvement opportunities with the, you know, Internet of Things, increasing connectivity. There's going to be more degree of automation that's going to increase both the operational margin of existing assets and also reduce the capex cost of new constructions.
Okay, how can investors then manage the rapidly evolving technological changes within the context of a long lifespan of infrastructure assets?
You're right that the asset class is a very long lifespan one, but I think investors tend to hold the assets for a period where they can use their skill set to experience the re-rating of the assets when the assets are de-risked, when commercialization risk, construction risks are reduced during their holding period. So I think the investors need to be very cognizant about both the regulatory and technological development of the areas they are investing in and staying tuned to the latest technology available. They need to partner with the right construction partners, development partners, to make sure that whatever they're doing is fully equipped with the latest iteration of technology. And they need to keep watching the unit economics of their output, because I think that will certainly have an impact on the fundamental supply and demand of the assets that they're developing or they're owning.
And your advice on the next 12 months, the outlook for this space, the infrastructure investment space, what's your advice and outlook?
I think we're talking about very enduring trends that are going to impact us in the many years to come. It's a very iterative and evolving area, well beyond the 12-month scope. So I would think that it puts a lot of emphasis on GPs to partner, to develop their in-house skills on the regulatory as well as technology awareness and mindfulness, and also to partner with the right parties to do the development.
Jie Gong, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you, Sarah.
Thank you for joining us. And if you want to see more from Super Return Asia, please look to Twitter and you can find the hashtag SRAsia. Thanks for joining us.